you remember your first blowjob?
Yeah. I wrote an article about it.
How long did it take the guy to bust in your mouth?
People! Welcome back to the greatest fucking show on planet Earth. Gasworks, you know the rest. You get me? We're doing well. All these things. I was saying 100,000 views every episode, blah, blah, blah. NFTR, whatever. Everyone, stay in your own lane. I'll be honest, yeah. Normally, before we get the guest on, we sit here and talk for a good, like, 20 minutes and just talk about things before they come on, and then we get their opinion on different topics. Blood, this is going to be, I don't care, it's not arguably, it's not, this is going to be the realest episode ever. The realest episode ever. We've got Lordy, fam. Man's been reporting the grime scene for forever. As long as I've been alive, fam.
Forever.
So I don't even want to talk about anything, get into any topics until he's sat right beside us. So people, please, give it up for the legendary man like Grime Report TV himself, man like Lordy.
You smell fresh as fuck, boy.
Yeah, you smell good, man. No homo.
You can't say that to a guy and then say, you know, I'm worried about you, fam. I'm starting to think about you, fam. You did it to yourself as well.
No, but fam, in the green room, you telling me how you're hugging other men and they were making your jumper smell.
Like. Yeah, your thing in a boiler room. Clean, yeah. Tell her to bring some socks. Car man, a man don't do feet. Yeah. Only problem I got is how to turn down all this weed. Yeah. Puff, 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 puff. Hey, listen, see, up with me. Someone hugged me, yeah, and I fucking stunk. My jumper, that jumper's ruined now.
Completely.
Ruined, I can't wear it again.
She giving it to them.
I don't know who it was, innit? If I knew who it was.
So basically, we were doing a call out. We want to give a jumper that used to belong to Lordy because he wants to throw it away and
if
give
you
it
hugged
to
Lordy,
you.
If you hug Lordy at my party.
And you smell, we have a jumper for you.
Fuck that. I can swear, Connor.
Yeah. Come cool. On, man.
It's the internet.
Fuck the algorithm. Listen. Gifts.
You're moving like Soldier Boy. Is this
man
yours?
Like Lordy, you know?
No, that's for you, fam.
Lordy, yeah, like, I'm blushing, you know?
Make it?
You know what Lordy got me for my birthday? Oh my God. What is this? A fucking... Aye, Lordy.
Wait, so when you're doing bulk cap, fam, yeah?
Yeah.
Can you imagine you doing bulk cap with that one?
You know, Lordy got me an eye massager for my birthday.
Eye massager?
Now when I eat my wife here, I put the eye massager on. Blood, we're in a VR pack. Hey, what? Man can watch VR porn to this?
Yes, and you can do bulk at the same time, fam.
So what's this
thing? Oh my God.
That's a game system, innit? You plug it into your TV and then you can just be playing 200 games.
Are you serious?
Yeah, look on the box, fam. 200 retro games, fam. I know you like retro stuff, innit?
Oh, you're such a nice person.
Fam, Lordy's the only person to ever bring us a gift, you know?
Wow.
Hey, Lordy.
This is so lit.
John, have you watched 3D porn before?
No. Cause
lying,
I don't.
Man.
What do you mean? Of course, that's I wouldn't lie about that. I would
you've
say I've
never
watched
3D porn before.
I didn't know it exists. I'm still out here just watching my conventional black girls and Colombian things.
Certainly, blood. You're the only person to ever bring us gifts, you know.
That
but
is lit. Thank you, bro. I appreciate that.
I got a gift for you as well. So you know the thing you're known for, the thing that I done recently as well. Well, that's a bit folded, but obviously my £5 munch turned into a £10 munch. So.
You can get this for 75p, yeah? Yeah, you can get that for 75p. Or for 25 pence more, you can just roof it and get this one.
Roof it, fam.
Yeah?
Do you know what, fam? I'm putting you back up to a tenner, man. Do you know what, yeah?
Really?
Man's just making me feel sentimental, isn't it? They call me Willie,
stay so cool, I'm chele. That's basically for you to get a £10 munch after the show. Lordy, the question we like to ask all our special guests, my friend, are you a bowcat?
Bro, I'm not here to answer. Listen. Do you remember your first blowjob?
Huh?
Do you remember your first blowjob?
Yeah. I wrote an article about it.
How long did it take the guy to bust in your mouth?
What? So you're not a bowcat? Come on, man. I can't imagine you're a bowcat, you know, with that deep voice.
Oh, how much sushi do you eat a week?
Sushi?
Yeah.
It depends.
You like sushi?
Not really. No, I can, like, it's there, innit? But people that...
When you're having withdrawals from that eating poom, do you think about that going to the sushi
bar?
Nah,
yeah, I think
like
of like sashimi and raw salmon there. Yeah. But it can't be smelling, it has to be fresh, like cut on the counter.
No, I hear that still.
Get me your sushi, but
you can't ask me about that what I eat and that. Not like what the, like, eating in a bedroom in it, from I'm an expert bedroom don, you know?
Talking of eating in a bedroom, you know, I think people that eat their dinner on the bed, tramps. People that eat their dinner on the bed are tramps.
I don't do that.
Where?
How can you eat your dinner on the bed? That's where you sleep. How can you just sit on there with a plate of food and just start munching?
You never given your girl breakfast in bed?
No, not breakfast in bed, but you can get up and sit on the
counter. But you eat in bed, innit?
Yeah. You know what I mean? That's a little bit different, man. That's a little bit different. Hey, Lords, man. Talk to them. The realest in the scene. Grand Report TV. How long has that been about now?
I think about 8 years. Maybe
more. Fucking hell, bro.
Do you know what I was doing 8 years ago? 8 years ago, 2011.
I was in That's a Rap.
Mad.
Fuck.
That's a Rap show. So, what was saying? Graham's dead, isn't it?
It's just going through a down patch, innit? Like, all music's go through ups and downs, innit? Like, Graham should be in a much better place, like realistically, and especially for how music is now, that like we're streaming, and it should be in a 10 times better place. It's like nostalgia based, innit? It's nostalgia based music. It's not a bad thing, yeah? It's not a bad thing.
The thing is, there's hundreds of up and coming MCs, of these new MCs. Like Lord of the Match is full of them. No one cares about them, fam.
Whose fault is that? Is that the. Whose fault is it? Is it collectively? Is it Graham listeners?
I think as well, a lot of people don't know how to make tunes.
I think that's it's a big part of it. That.
Yeah, and there's no excuses. Like, I'm not about excuses, either. I'm not, you know, I don't want to hear nothing. I ain't got the money. I want to hear that. Do you understand?
You've got to get results.
Find it. Do you understand? If you believe in what you're doing, you
make it work.
Beg, borrow, steal. What's the other? Kill? I don't know the thing saying. No, I don't know the saying. You do whatever by a crew or by a hook or whatever. I don't know.
Hook or by crook to go get it done.
Yeah.
And when you think about what Graham stemmed from, it stemmed from a bag of people going to find their way to get their voice on a radio station, which was a pirate radio station, and then you have to fight to get your wheel up, and then once you fought to get a wheel up, you could go to more sets, and it's but built from nothing. There was no money there anyway, so exactly. For that to be an excuse today, when there's more avenues for you to present your music, it's a bit like,
rubbish.
But this is the thing, like, I can understand why people are using it as an excuse nowadays anyway. Because you do need the budget to make that big video. You do need the budget to make
it's
sure
it's a journey.
Yourself.
You can't expect of to have course. The end of the journey at the start.
But this is my point.
Brother, the journey, so the your journey music, is here go now. Go to Camden and sell CDs. That, but, use that money to shoot videos.
The journey's here now. Like, Graham's here. Graham's here. Graham used to be here. But this was my point earlier. Graham's here right now. So if you're here, no one cares about you because Graham's here. Mm-hmm. Like Skepta's on the front row of Chanel. Skepta's doing this and Stormzy's done that and Jammer's up there and Graham is here right now. So. That's what I'm saying. These new up-and-comers that don't have money, that don't have any label backing, that don't have, you know, pirate radio stations to go to.
You don't need money to be creative, innit? Yeah?
No, you don't. Right?
If you haven't got money, then you should actually be more creative than people and be thinking on a, do you understand, on a more creative frequency. Level rather than worrying about, oh.
If I had this, what I could do? Because you don't have it, so you never even know anyway. Because when you get it, who knows what you're thinking then? At the end of the day, Alhan, I kind of agree with Lordy because you're 19 years old and I can make all the excuses 20 in 20. You're 20 years old and I've got emails from you when you were 14 asking to collaborate and work together. And if we worked off the philosophy that you have right now, then arguably you shouldn't be sitting beside me us doing any work, if we're being honest.
No,
so
I don't think no one cares about these youngers.
I'm going to get hated for this, innit? Yeah. Minor. Used to it. A lot of Dons and Graham are fucking boring as fuck. Like, when I hang out with them, they are boring people. They are fucking just...
It's the truth.
Damp, dishwasher, boring, vanilla Dons. That's half of the
vanilla
thing.
Dons?
Yes, just vanilla ice cream, plain.
Not with a sprinkle?
Fam, there's no rebels. I don't see any rebels. I see man that ain't just trying to follow every rule,
no character,
do everything, just be... There was a Fed in Graham, there was a fucking police officer doing Graham sets, scanning Graham sets, doing sets. Last year there was a Fed going around doing Graham sets, a Fed, yeah, police officer, and nobody had a problem with it. Like everyone's like, oh, he should be allowed to do it, it's just music, yeah?
What, a policeman was
a
going?
A policeman was doing, he had pictures of him, someone exposed him with his police uniform
and badges.
And then he said, you know what, fuck you guys, I'm just going to be a Fed now from now on. And he's just a
that's what you
Fed
from
now
on. Everyone's fucking hating the press now.
That's what's fucking everything up. See, comedy. Comedy's dead now. You see, comedy.
Comedy's finished, blood.
All you're going to see it's from finished. Now on is, hey guys, I'm happy to be here. Oh, look, it's all...
Not really, because you've got Alhan here, and Alhan is lit.
Yeah, but I'll
Alhan's
going to
get counselled, bro.
Yeah, he won't.
Alhan is about to get counselled.
Do you know
counseled.
Why? Do you
I'm
know
going
why
to get, Alhan, you get counselled, yeah? I've got your
don't
back,
say,
bro.
Don't say that.
I've got your
you're sitting
back,
down.
Lordy,
love, fam, love, love.
You'll never be royal. Lordy, listen, what I'm saying.
I'm not royal.
No, that's a great song
but
by Lordy.
I'm the cockroach.
This is all right. It's a song by Lordy, but don't worry.
Alhan's a cockroach as well, man.
Alhan, with his wonderful, wonderful energy, is able to attract an audience of people that it doesn't matter if he gets cancelled, they still fuck with him. And if that is like 20...
energy.
No, he hasn't. I went to his birthday the other day. Nick, you were there. Everyone loves him. It's all lies.
You were hugging boys, bro.
You were hugging boys and getting sweaty. This is what he told me. I think you should take it out on him, but that's another situation. My point is this. We shouldn't say he's going to get cancelled because he's not.
Bro, I was showing a man in love, you. Yeah. It wasn't hugging no girl. I was showing a man in love, yeah.
Listen, for you to wash your jumper and it still stinks of my man, that was a squeeze, blood. That was a squeeze. Lodi, you're my guy, but can't lie.
Bro, that's some MC with bad self-hygiene.
Oh, it was an MC.
I know who it was.
Was it MC?
Yeah.
I know who it was. It's Nasty Jack.
Don't fucking ever say that about Nasty Jack. Shut the fuck up, man. It wasn't Nasty Jack, man. Don't say that, bro.
Discard her.
Don't say no names, man. This is why I say you're gonna get counseled, bro. Listen, right, you see with
that's
you,
not cancellation.
Owlhead. You're either gonna get counseled or you're gonna be one of them videos with man them trying to run up on you.
But man,
and then I'm gonna have to come through with the gypsies. True. Yeah?
We'll do a 5 pound munch as well.
On
well,
some
yeah.
next thing that you have not seen. Don't fuck with Owlhead, yeah. You leave this guy alone, yeah. He's a bit gobby in that, yeah, but he's family, just
thank
leave
you,
him alone, yeah.
Thank
yeah?
you very much.
And as for the counselling thing, you see that counselling, I can't help you on the counselling thing, but I've got your back,
we
yeah.
We spoke this, blood.
When they
we spoke
counsel
about
you,
this.
Bro, I've got your back, yeah.
Fam,
yeah?
Cancelled culture is done out here. It's cancelled in itself.
I think no it's cancelled in
yeah,
itself.
Yeah, they run out of people to cancel.
Hold on.
So they start in
I writing. Love cancellation, but where were you at my activation? So you want to cancel me, but you didn't activate me. So how can you cancel me?
I'm a
but
tree.
This is the thing. In this day and age, everyone's got some fucking trauma. When this is the thing that really...
No one gives a fuck about your trauma, yeah? Fuck yourself, yeah? Don't be complaining all the time about shit. Just fuck off and just
get
have a
grip.
Go for a walk, smoke something, drink. Do
just
boxing,
grip,
do karate or something, innit? Don't be complaining all the time, though, and think anyone gives a fuck anyway, because I don't give a fuck. That fuck your problem.
It's the
right?
truth. You go on Twitter, truth. I said this. If you're feeling down, if you're feeling upset, don't talk to me. I don't want to hear it. Mm. I don't want to hear it, fam. When you go on Twitter or Instagram, all you see is mental health. Listen, I'll write you a check. I'll write you a check for 25 bags, yeah? Mm. If you just spend a day online, and you don't see fucking 50 things about mental health and
no,
shit.
No, but bro, that's a touchy subject because
of course it's a touchy subject.
From mental
no,
health
I understand that, and that is a real problem. But there's people that aren't qualified.
Does anyone want some Buckfuss?
What is Buckfuss? Is that a soft drink?
Yeah, it's a soft drink. I used to think that depression was just fake.
Yeah,
I used to think that these things was just old job centre thing. Like, oh, if man wants to get money from the job centre, I'm not jeering on all these scams, innit?
Yeah.
If you want to get money from job centre, say you've got depression. But the best one that no one busses no more, if you want to get money from job centre, yeah, say you're addicted to speed. You see, you broke motherfuckers that want to get quick cash, yeah? Go and say you're addicted to speed, yeah? They can't prove that you are and they can't prove that you aren't. You go in the doctors, you just say to the doctor, I'm addicted to speed, I can't stop taking amphetamines. And they say, oh, how do you feel when you just like push the table over? They just sign you off.
push the table over,
fam. 6 months, you ain't gonna work one
quickly,
day, man. Trust me.
Quickly.
I used to think depression was like that, but
I used to think the same. I'll be honest. I used to be very ignorant because I was young, because these things didn't affect me. I was like, yeah, fuck that. It's all bollocks. It's not real. It's all in your mind. But it has affected me in the past. I have had my own experiences. There's blood. My problem here was I went online and I typed in, this is what happened to me, and I just found people talking, and that's what drove me mad.
Was it eating pum-pum?
It gave me paranoia, yeah.
Started everything off you.
Blood.
You couldn't eat
but
no
where did
pum-pum.
She was bleeding while I was doing it.
Don't say that.
That's disgusting. Where did you go online to talk
basically,
about it?
I went on Reddit, yeah, and typed in my symptoms or like the way I was feeling, and I saw people talking and paragraphs of it. You've got this, and just, I started self-diagnosing myself. I was like, raw.
So why did you go there for?
Hmm?
Why did you go there?
Because while I'm trying to find answers, but if anything, I'm leaving with more questions. Blood is hot, but I don't take my hoodie off because I'm fat.
Was it you that pointed out that there was a thing called,
probably not too bad.
What's that thing on the back of girls' legs? Cellulite. I swear it was you.
Mm-mm. I wouldn't care about that.
It's almost smart that I watch. It's probably him, like. But there was a thing called cellulite, innit? Yeah? But companies invented cellulite, innit? Like it was just the back of girls' legs. That's what it was called before.
Just normal stuff.
Yeah, and then they invented a name for it called cellulite and then convinced girls that you've got cellulite and you need to get rid of it. It's a multi-million pound industry, isn't it? Yeah, and that's all that online is.
Lordy, this is my problem because I've realised this was my problem last year. So let's go to, I don't know, Instagram. I've gone onto Instagram. I've seen Jamie Redknapp. There's Raid, nice guy. Louis White, my mate, Conan. Do you know how much information I'm consuming right this minute? Is this really healthy? Do I need to know what everyone's fucking doing with their lives right now?
My Insta got locked off, yeah, and I will not lie to you, yeah? when I stopped seeing what everyone else is doing, yeah, I just got back to making videos I wanted to make. Yeah, I ain't gonna lie to you, I swear down, yeah, like I clocked, yeah, because you end up naturally comparing yourself to what other people's doing, start thinking, do you fit in? Yeah, who gives a fuck if you fit? You die when you're gonna die, and you're gonna die on your own, innit? Yeah, so why are you trying to fit in for? Who gives a fuck if you fit in?
I feel like you should be the best person that you can be and be.
That's it, bro, just do you, man. Fuck what people's got to say, you'll be all right, man. You're incredible, you're great, you're wonderful, yeah, look in the mirror, tell yourself that. You will beat them chicks that you want to beat. Not all the time, but once in a while you will. Remember that, yeah?
Apart from Miles. Miles, nothing's going to happen to
him. He wears Jack Rules.
Yeah, he wears Jack Rules. Trump. And he done a Lynx advert where he was shaving himself slowly, whispering. So not Miles, but everybody else, yes.
Lodi, you are undeniably the man that made Big Nasty famous, in my eyes. Uncle Payne was a hit online Massive. Series. Huge, the biggest online show probably to come out of the UK. But when you go Massive. On YouTube and type in Uncle Payne now, none of them videos are about no more. Obviously, he's gone on to do the Channel 4 show and stuff, but where are the videos, man?
You've answered the question.
You've answered it.
That. There's no, God bless Nasty, man, it's my brother, innit? Like, no matter what, like, people can say anything. That's my brother. And my little brother Femi, who I love, I've had periods where I don't speak to him for a bit, innit? It's just you grow in different directions sometimes, innit? Like, you might have an idea that you don't want to do, innit? And you might have an idea that you don't want to do, but you strongly believe in, innit? Yeah. And that's, I'll just leave it to that, man. The rest of it is just, I don't know who was reporting the videos on YouTube, all the videos just started to get reported all of a sudden, innit? So it's smarter that I take them. Because I feel bad, yeah, let me be honest, I feel bad not explaining to the viewers every 5 minutes. I get messages, what happened to Uncle Payne? What happened to Uncle Payne? Do you understand? Like, I don't want to go online and then start
pointing. Yeah, of course.
So I'm coming from
at least you can explain yourself properly.
Yeah, and it's not, there's no animosity, there's not nothing in it. Three strikes, you're off YouTube, innit?
Yeah, 100%.
I had two strikes at one point, innit? So what's the smartest thing to do?
Shut them off.
Do you understand?
And they were just basically reporting every nasty video.
Basically.
Obviously trying to clean up his image or...
I don't know that for definite. I'm not saying that.
I know you're not saying
I've never spoken to nobody at YouTube. I don't even have 100,000. People's getting more 100,000 subscriber plaques. You can get two of them now if you want, or three. Yeah? I don't even have the original one. I've never spoken to nobody at no YouTube or nothing. Do you understand? Ever.
That's mad. So someone just started reporting all the big Nasty videos at the time where he's.
I wouldn't imagine it was anyone from Nasty's camp, but I can imagine it might have been Channel 4 or
it's
someone.
Definitely
trying
not
to
Nasty. He's not going to sabotage his own thing. But the smartest thing to do is
to just save yourself because one more strike and that's the end of Grand Report TV.
I can't lie, that ain't nice.
What's been your favorite thing to work on with Grand Report? Because I said this when I done my £5 munch. Yeah, if you look at £5 munch, that is UK culture summed up. Like in the US, you got Complex that do like sneaker shopping with whatever rapper or sneaker shopping with whatever Hollywood star.
Big up Complex and big up Sean because they've not done a £5 munch, you know?
Yeah, I see that. So I see they gave you a shout out still.
Quickly.
The UK's equivalent is the £5 munch. Because here, like the off licenses and corner shops and boss man behind the counter, like, that's a big part of our culture. Like everyone, doesn't matter where you are unless you're in fucking the Cotswolds, grew up around the fucking corner shop.
Yeah.
And it's a big part of our life on the way to school, on the way back from school, weekends. Like the corner shop is where, like corner shop workers, I see someone say this the other day as well, see you grow up. Like they see you come in from when you're fucking 5 or whatever, all the way to your 105. But
one of my favourite people, is Angry Shopkeeper, innit? And he's a shopkeeper.
Right, this is one thing I've never understood. Warm beer, who wants warm beer?
Waste Man Street warm beer, innit?
Sod that, you don't want warm beer.
People always say to me, how come you two friends? How did you meet him? Like, don't you chat to people in your street? Don't you chat to people you see every day? Like,
some people don't,
Some people are socially
awkward. That's how your life is rubbish, though, isn't it? Do you understand?
But then again, on my area, I don't talk to absolutely nobody.
Did you just move there?
I've been there for just moved there like 3-4 years.
I swear.
And they also tried to report me to the police.
Where?
Tried to say I was a drug dealer.
It's because there's an M&S on the high street.
Was he shorting, fam? Not that. Was
me?
Yeah.
Me? mate, I'll get robbed in a heartbeat. How do I convince this goon that I want to take like £40 for whatever he... Yes, £40, please. You ain't getting none. What do I do after that?
You would
be all right, like, well, I'll be back with some goons. I'm never going to come on, cuz. Cuz, I couldn't believe it.
Hey, what, Bobby and Whitney, yeah? Like, poet, innit? Like, say, I mean, P, yeah?
I got a letter and a phone call. They were like, yeah, so... I was like, mate, you can send the police. I'll have a conversation with them because I don't understand.
That's dick as shit, man. That's
so they,
shit,
if people are in similar situations shit, yeah. like me, I don't talk to no one on my road.
No, but it depends on who, innit?
Majority of the people. When you walk in shops and that, you talk to people.
No.
I've seen you. When you walk in, you say hello to people. Yeah.
Yeah, the shopkeeper's lit.
Yeah, of course. Nice like,
I can live in my area for 3 days and not spend a penny if I needed to. I swear down.
They got you like that?
Yeah.
You're a real guy, though.
No, just be safe with everyone. This is what this is. When people see things certain times, I try to explain to the YGs and that, innit, yeah? Just be
cool, yeah.
I'll speak to that guy if I see him outside. I'll just remember him, innit, and I'll just say hello to him, innit. Do you understand? 90% of people don't, yeah? And it's nothing. And I've met your sister and I've met your mum.
That's true, still.
So we're pretty much family. You lot can come to my house. Dinner,
you know, you can come to my house. There's not much food there, but you can come, as you can see.
You can come to the trap, innit? If you come to the trap, yeah?
First person in the UK.
You can eat pizza off the heater, rude wear. Like, you can come and eat pizza heated up by the heater.
That's lit, though.
Mm. Or on the iron, you know, when you put the iron upside down, because one slice fits perfectly.
Cheese toasties.
Bro, you've never had to deal with that. You went to a private school.
Yeah, exactly.
You don't have no problem
with
that.
I'm not going to teach y'all hand them things.
In boarding school, you take the iron. That's when you do it the most, isn't it?
Did you go boarding school?
Yeah.
That's why you're like this.
Trust me, my guy, come on.
Was there girls there?
Nah, but we were in a separate corridor.
Oh,
still.
Shit.
Was you bored in school?
I seen what you said the other day about... And this is why I say big up Gasworks, innit, yeah? Because I really commend the fact that you've got Boiler Room.
Trust me.
Support a show that is definitely not going to be appealing to advertisers and stuff like that because of the content, yeah? But still support the thing because it's needed, yeah? Right?
Yeah.
Now, that's the same problem I get, do you understand? Like, I don't do the, hey guys, it's Lordy here. I'm here with Alhan and Poet. Yeah. We're going to talk about jelly. Like, what jelly do you like, Alhan? I like red jelly. What one do you like? Do you like when your mum makes custard, Poet?
I don't know my mum.
Don't you know your mum?
She hates me.
She hates you?
Yes.
Oh, no, that's really sad. Anyway, what we're going to do is we're going to move on to... I don't make shows like that. I don't know how
to... To be honest with you, Gasworks makes me lose money. I lose money because of Gasworks. I've lost out on a deal for about 70 bags because of Gasworks. So I'm just past the point in caring about, like, what the general public...
No, brother, listen, your cultural... The thing is, this is this. What I clocked here is that it's not... Stat number one and number two is this, innit, yeah? Gasworks is something that people will be able to watch in the future, in the future, innit, yeah? No, it is because of the way the thing is, innit? Do you understand that? If you look at, let's say, Press T. If you use, like, say, some kid's going to come across Press T and say, who is he? Do you understand? As long as everything's preserved on YouTube,
then we'll always
these are
find
things
out,
that you can go back and watch. I watched this thing and Tupac said, don't mention the name or the year of the car. Just call it a Mercedes. Don't say what make it is. Don't say what brands you're wearing on or think like that, yeah? Because in future 10 years' time, them things ain't going to have nothing to do with nothing and it's going to make the music dated.
Wow.
Do you understand?
He is lit. Tupac was lit. He died at like 24, 25. Imagine if that guy lived to like 50. That's why in America, there is some great examples of people in America. Just like there's some fantastic examples of people in England. Mm. Look at you, Lordy. But there's also some really poor examples of people everywhere as well.
Lordy, thank you very much for coming on our show. Any last words?
You mean any last words? Like, I ain't getting my head chopped off, bro.
It's true.
That sounds horrible, man. Don't say any last words. Say something like, what you got to say to the ops on the ends? Like, something like that. You should have, like, some flick.
Is the B on your chain for Boca? Thank you, my brother.
Where the ball catching?
Oh, it's heavy.
Where the ball catching? Where the ball catching?
It's a really nice chain.
Thank you very much. B is for Boca.
Yeah, it is what it is.
Boiler room. Let me phone you back in 30 seconds. I'm going to kick you back right now. I'm filming. 2 seconds. I missed you.
How dare you answer your phone during an interview?
Because I told these lot I have to be gone by 5. I didn't even realise it was 5:30. And the place that I'm meant to be right now, they just phoned
everything
me.
Everything was going good and you said to spoil it, poet.
I'm sorry. My parents said the same thing when I was born.
Lordy, make some noise, people.